The diagnosis of breast cancer somehow evolves in the minds of patients that they're going to automatically lose their hair. This is certainly not necessarily the case. At Breast Cancer Answers, we have videos by my colleagues, Dr. David Margulith and Dr. Afshin Forazania, that talk about the potential of hair loss with chemotherapy and radiation therapy, and I would refer you to those videos. But, you know, I guess I'm surprised, but yet I'm not surprised, because when the diagnosis of breast cancer is made, women immediately think of friends they've had with breast cancer who have automatically lost their hair. As I've shared with other videos here at Breast Cancer Answers, breast cancer is a galaxy of diseases. So as a good example, the in situ breast cancers do not require chemotherapy, certainly may require radiation therapy, and there's no thought in any of our minds that somebody's going to be losing their hair over the treatment of in situ breast cancers. And even with certain invasive cancers, we may not be needing chemotherapy at all, particularly when we've done something like an oncotype DX analysis, which shows that there's no benefit of chemotherapy. So please don't be frightened by the diagnosis. Please do not automatically think that the diagnosis of breast cancer means I'm going to lose my hair. Such is not always the case. Hi, I'm Dr. Jay Harness, and I want to share with you important information that I believe that every newly diagnosed patient with breast cancer needs to know.
I'm a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
I am a breast cancer survivor.
And I want every woman to know
about personalized breast cancer treatment
and the genomic test.
A test that helps guide a woman and her doctor
to the best treatment options for her.
Pass it on.